Begin, then I'll speak. Yeah, good afternoon and welcome back to the class. We are at the end of our chapter on data handling, where we are going to deal with exercise 5.3 today. So before I take up the exercise 5.3, I have a short video which discusses about a deck of cards. Do you know what is a deck of cards? Playing cards. Deck of playing cards. Have you seen a set of playing cards? Have you played with it?
I've seen, ma'am, but I've not played.
You've not played with it. Okay, but you should know how a deck is constituted. Means what are all the different varieties of cards which are available in a deck of cards. Because in a chapter like probability, definitely there will be questions based on a deck of cards. It is there in your exercise also, in exercise 5.3. So before I get into that exercise, let me try to show you what a deck of cards look like and what are the different varieties of cards which are available in a set of cards. Okay, so for which I'm going to share my screen. Are you seeing my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Pin the screen so that there is no distraction later on. So I'm going to mute from here. I will play the video now.
Now, a pack of cards is generally known as a standard deck of cards. In most of the games, or you can say in mostly games, the standard deck of cards or the standard pack of cards is used. Now, there are 52 well-shuffled cards in this standard deck of cards. Now, these 52 cards, they are actually divided into four categories or four suits known as spades, hearts, diamonds, and clubs. You can very well see that spades and clubs are black in color and hearts and diamonds are red in color. So, you can see that the standard deck of cards, it is divided into four suits, two of the same color, black and red. Now, generally, these names are not written on the cards. Instead, these symbols are used to represent these names. So, whenever you see such a symbol on a card, you can say that it is a spade card. Whenever you see a heart symbol on a card, you can say it is a card of hearts. Whenever you see a diamond symbol, you can say it belongs to diamonds. And similarly, whenever you see a club, that represents a club card.
Now, why I paused here was I want you to draw these suits in your classwork. All right. You will write the heading as standard deck of cards. And you will tell there are four varieties. Four suits means there are four varieties, four different symbols. Okay. So that is the spades, hearts, diamonds, and clubs. The clubs and the spades will be black in color. The hearts and the diamonds are in red color. So better shade it in those colors only with this shape drawn. All right?
Okay. Come on.
Now, there are always three face cards in each of these suits. They are known as king, queen, and jack. So you will find three face cards in each suit. Here you can see that these face cards here represents cards of hearts. You can see the heart symbol here. Similarly, you will see these three cards in all the four suits representing diamonds, spades, and clubs also. So can you tell me how many face cards are there in the total pack of cards? If there are three in each suit and there are four suits in total. So 3 into 4, will it give us 12? So we can say that there are 12 face cards in the total standard deck of cards. Now, the other cards, leaving aside the face cards, are known as the pip cards. They are the ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So the cards from ace to 10, they are known as pip cards. So there are 10 pip cards in each suit.
Okay. Now, why I paused here was you must know there are two varieties of cards in every symbol or in every suit. So if you take the spades, there will be two varieties, that is the face cards and the pip cards. Now, pip cards are also called number cards. Okay. So when we start with the numbering, we don't start with one. We start with ace. So ace represents one actually. But it is not given that number one in the cards. It is told or it is pronounced as ace card. So after ace, you will have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So in all, there will be 10 pip cards or 10 number cards starting from ace till 10. And this will be repeated for all the four symbols or all the four suits. So there will be 10 pip cards in spades, 10 pip cards in clubs, 10 pip cards in diamonds and 10 pip cards in hearts. All right. So 10 into 4. How many cards totally done?
Yes, ma'am. 40. Ma'am, 40. And 40. Face cards, 3 will be there.
Yeah.
Face cards, 1 are it will 12. Be 13.
Yeah. Because there are 4 suits and 3 face cards. So totally 4 into 3, there will be 12 face cards. So a total deck of cards will have 40 plus 12. Which is 52. So that is how your deck is becoming a total of 52.
Ma'am, but we didn't include the joker here.
They yes, the jokers are extra cards actually. They are not included in the deck. These joker cards are used only in certain games which are played using the cards. They are not actually in the group. They are introduced because some games with the playing cards are played using the joker. So when we talk about a deck of cards, we will never include the joker in it. It is just for your information, she is telling you there is another variety because when you buy a deck of cards, you will have 54 cards in it. 52, which is the usual, plus 2 jokers. All right. Joker does not have any value. It is like a extra card. All right. So we'll proceed.
We know that there are 4 suits and there are 10 pip cards in each suit. So how many pip cards are there in total? Well, 10 into 4 gives us 40 pip cards in total. Now, there may be 2 or 3 jokers in your pack of cards. But these jokers, they are not included or counted in these 52 standard deck of cards. So what did you study in total? That there are total 52 cards and they are divided into 4 categories, namely clubs, spades, hearts and diamonds, which are represented by these symbols respectively. Now
again I have paused here because I want this tabular column to be prepared in your notebook. So this should remain in your memory for another 3 years. If
and
I
actually here, queen and king is also there. No, ma'am, should we draw them?
No need. It is exactly like this. You have to draw the tabular column. That's
only
why
only the tabular column you have to draw.
Yes, tabular column you have to draw. And this okay. I'm doing it this year because I want this in your memory for another 3 years. Ma'am, if at all I happen to take class 10 for you, I will not be repeating all this because in class 10 we have number of questions based on deck of cards. So if it is introduced and told to you this year, please have it in your memory till another 3 years. Because probability in 9th standard also has got deck of cards. Probability in 10th standard also is dealing with deck of cards. Yes,
ma'am, I have a doubt, ma'am. Mm-hmm. In the before some time, actually, there was a card in which king and queen and another Jack. Character was drawn. Should we draw that?
Jack. No. I never said that. No. That's why I am only speaking where I want you to do it in the classwork.
Okay.
Only when I say it will be done. Okay. Because I know I don't want drawing and all to all be right. done. I have no relevance to the drawing at all. I want you to be sure what are the different varieties of cards and what are the different symbols in the cards.
Yes, ma'am. We have and to totally draw the symbols and number of cards in this tabular form.
Yeah. Kushi, tell me.
Ma'am, should we write the letters which they have written in the side?
Exactly as it is written there in the tabular column, I want you to reproduce in your classwork.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Any more doubt?
No, ma'am.
साइड अली है टॉप्स इधर है थ्री फेस कार्ड्स 10 पिप कार्ड्स 26 कार्ड्स इन ईच कलर 2 टू 4 जोकर्स इतना बेकादरू बरीरी इल्ल अंद्रे ओनली जोकर्स आई एम नॉट वेरी पर्टिकुलर बट ऑल दिस आफ्टर ड्रॉइंग द टैब्लो कॉलम दिस साइड दे हैव रिटन नो दिस आल्सो इज टू बी रिटन एंड टोटल इज 52 ಅಂತಾನೂ ಬರಿಬೇಕು ಮೇಲೆ ಕ್ಲಬ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಪೇಡ್ಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಡೈಮಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಾನೂ ಬರಿಬೇಕು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ಯಾ
ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ಓಕೆ ಶಾಲ್ ವಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಡ್
KQNJ, these three are known as face cards. And there are three face cards present in each suit. So there are total 12 face cards in the standard deck of cards. Now remaining cards, that is from 10 to the ace, or the ace to the 10, they are known as pip cards. And there are 10 pip cards in each suit. So there are 40 pip cards in total. Now we can say that there are 13 cards in total. Now we can say that there are 13 cards in each suit. Now two suits are of the same color. So can you tell me how many cards do we have of the same color? Say black, 13 plus 13, that is 26. And of red, we have 13 plus 13, that is 26.
If possible, maintain the colors also. Clubs and spades, write it in black. Hearts and diamonds, write it in red. So that it is clear. That there are only two colors available on the deck of cards, out of which two suits, that is the clubs and spades, are in black. The hearts and diamonds are in red.
Ma'am, we should write in red pen, or we can give a shade of red in color pencils.
If you have a color pencil, please do it in color pencil, because red is used only by the teacher. You don't use it. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. We will use. Ma'am, but when we write using a color pencil,
only the symbols you are writing, no, Arvan. Only K, Q, J, 10, 9, 8 you are writing. What is there? The other one is a diagram. You have to draw it. That's all.
Yeah, ma'am. Small here, 10, club. 9, 8 it is written. Ma'am, A to 10.
You have to write
it
in red and black. Okay. Yeah.
So you can say that there are 26 cards of each color. 26 black cards, including clubs and spades, and 26 red cards, including hearts and diamonds. Now there may be 2, 3, 4 jokers in your pack of cards, but they are not counted in the 52 cards, so they do not belong to those standard deck of cards. Now let's do a problem on cards. A card is drawn from a standard deck of cards. Okay, now you know what is a standard deck of cards. It contains 52 cards in total. What is the probability that it is a six of hearts? Can you tell me the number 6, which card it belongs, face card or pip card? Well, it is a pip card, because the face cards are K, Q and J, that is King, Queen and Jack. So 6 belongs to a pip card. Now we know that probability of an event can be found out by number of favorable outcomes by total number of outcomes in the sample space. So your favorable outcomes, we have to find out for what? 6 of hearts. Now there can be only 1 6 of hearts in the total. Now if it was said that it is a 6 of red color, then we would have 6 of hearts and 6 of diamonds. So it would come as 2. But 6 of hearts is there only one card in the total standard deck of cards.
This problem you can write down in your classwork and complete it like this. The drawing that is done there is not necessary. Only write down the question. Write down the event is to get 6 of hearts. Then you should write the formula for probability is equal to number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. So numerator will become 1 because there is only 1 6 in the hearts. And the total number of outcomes will be 52 because there are 52 cards in total in the deck. Is that clear? Now I think I will stop the share here. I'm coming back to my screen. Okay, now I'm going to get back to the board because we are going to do exercise 5.3. I may not be doing all the problems there, but some of the problems I want to deal and do it in front of you so that you can complete it in your notes. Now, if you have your textbook, you can take your textbook and get ready. This is exercise 5.3 that we are doing. Okay, so now I'll get back to the board.
Yeah, are you seeing the board behind me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so we will start with our exercise 5.3 in page number 87. So take your textbook with you because I am going to discuss only some of the problems where I think you will require the help. Okay, now I am at the first problem. Are you looking at the problem? List the outcomes you can see in these experiments. So there are two events given to you or experiments given to you. Spinning a wheel and tossing two coins together. So spinning the wheel, how many portions are made for that wheel?
Ma'am, 5 portions.
Yeah, there are 5 portions made for that wheel. I don't know if you are seeing the textbook or simply looking at me. 1 minute.
15.
Let me share that screen. So quickly you will focus your attention there. Are you seeing my screen?
Ma'am, if you share, then we can't
see. No, that I know. That I know. Yeah, this is the page I'm talking about. Are you looking at this in your textbook? Exercise 5.3. I think you can spin between the two screens, no? I have one screen which is showing my presentation and one screen which is showing my board. Can you see there are 2 tabs there? Are you able to open both of them?
Yes, ma'am. At a time, we can't both
open. At a time, you don't have to open them. And I'm asking you to look at the problem, I will shift to the screen. And I'm asking you to look at my board, you shift to the screen. So that I don't have to stop share every time.
Ma'am, in the recording, will it your screen be pinned or the board screen will be pinned or the
presentation? I think my screen will come back. Okay, let us see. Once you are having your textbook, my problem is solved.
We are having our textbook.
Okay, okay. Are you looking at these 2 problems? Yeah, because I'm not going Okay, I'm not going to make you draw this again. You can simply write it in the textbook itself. The question is, list the outcomes you see in these experiments. So in this experiment of spinning a wheel, what is the total number of outcomes you will have?
Ma'am, 5.
5, because the entire circle is made out of 5 portions there. It can be A, B, C and D. So it is like spinning a wheel. I don't know if you have seen spinning a wheel. It is a game. The pointer will point at one of the alphabets shown there. And you win if you get a particular alphabet. It is like a gambling game. Alright. So this is the total number of outcomes of spinning this wheel is 5. You can write it down there on in the textbook. Total outcomes equals 5. Now for the second one, I have to come back to the board. It is then tossing 2 coins together. So when you toss 2 coins together, I'm coming back to my board. Okay, when you toss 2 coins together, what are the outcomes you think you can have?
No, total number of outcomes can be 4.
If I toss,
total number will be 4 outcomes.
There are 2 outcomes. It can be a head or it can be a tail. Now I have 2 coins and both are tossed together like this. It is simply kept like this and tossed. So what are the outcomes?
Ma'am, one can be
head and tail.
Ma'am, 2 head and 2 tails will be there, ma'am.
First point will be head, second point will be head. Or both of them can be tails.
Yes, ma'am.
First point of tail, second point of tail. Then it can be head in the first point and tail in the second point. Or it can be tail in the first point and head in the second point. So all these are outcomes of the experiment of tossing 2 coins together. So you can write outcomes will be head and head, tail and tail, head and tail, or tail and head. This is the outcomes of tossing 2 coins together. This also you write it down in your textbook itself. You don't have to completely write it down in the notebook again. only total outcomes they are asking. You should know that total outcomes are four, and the outcomes are head and head, tail and tail, head and tail, or tail and head. All right. Now moving on to the next question. Let me look at the next word. I'm over now. When a die is thrown, list the outcomes in the event of an event of getting a prime number. You have to only list the outcomes. You don't have to find the probability. So what is the experiment here? A die is thrown. So when a die is thrown, what are the total outcomes?
What are the total outcomes?
On this, can we write it in the notebook?
Yeah, your pressure number. Outcomes will be what? It can be 1, it can be 2, it can be 3, 4, 5, or 6. So these are the outcomes of experiment where a die is thrown or it is rolled out later. Now the question is, what is the outcome of an event of getting a prime number? If you want only prime number, what are the outcomes? Outcomes, this you write it as total outcomes. Outcomes for prime number. When you want your outcome to be prime number, which are the outcomes you should have? Which are the prime numbers in this numbers?
1, 2, 3, 5.
Ma'am, 2, 3, 5.
3 and 5. So these are the outcomes of getting a prime number. What is the second one which is asked? Not a prime number. Outcomes of not a prime number. Which are the ones?
Ma'am, 1, 4, 6.
Ma'am, 1,
1 4, and 6.
4, 6. Yeah.
The non-prime numbers are 1, 4, and 6. Can I include 1 here? I have a doubt I'm asking you. Can I include 1 here? Non-prime numbers. What do you know about 1? Is it a prime number or a composite number?
Ma'am, I said it is a neutral.
Sorry, please be louder. Is 1 a prime number or a composite number?
Ma'am, it is not a prime number. It is neutral, ma'am.
It is neutral.
Neither a prime nor a composite. For the 1 should not be included there. It is only 4 and...
Ma'am, I think you should tilt your camera a little down.
Down? You're not seeing this, that's all. This is the last line. That's all.
No, ma'am, down also a little bit over.
And now it is visible. If you write any line below that, it is visible.
So the non-prime numbers is 4 and 6. I am seeing 3 also. That's not a problem. If I tilt, it's a big problem. I have to adjust the camera here. It is standing on a tripod. Okay. Now,
the whole laptop is standing on a tripod.
It is telling a number greater than 5. So what are the outcomes to get a number greater than 5? Outcomes for?
Ma'am, only one number, it is
number
6.
Number greater than 5. Which is that?
6, ma'am.
It is only 6. What's the fourth one? Okay, this I have to shift my camera. So that I decide. Now, the fourth one is, what is the outcome for getting a number not greater than 5?
Ma'am, we have 1, 2, 3 and 4.
Ma'am, 1, 2, 3, 4.
What about 5?
1, 2, 3, 4 numbers are there.
Ma'am, they are
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Greater than 5.
Not greater than 5. So should I include 5 or not?
Ma'am, no.
Not greater than 5, include 5 or not? Are you sure? It is not.
We should include, ma'am.
We should include, ma'am.
Not greater than 5 means only 6 I should not include. 5 should be included. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Alright? So that was the second question. Now the next question that I want to take up is, okay, look at the third main, the second question. Okay, that also we can finish. We take the first, second, and the third, all the three questions we'll take quickly. Okay, the third main says, find the probability of the pointer stopping on B in question number 1A. If the pointer has to stop at the alphabet B, what is the probability? So first you have to define the event. Always you should define the event when you are finding the probability of an event. So here, I am going out of the screen. E is the event, E is pointer pointing at P. Okay, now you want to find the probability of this event E. So P of E and the buzzer. You don't have to write it in words. If you write E within bracket P, it is read as probability of event E. The event is, the pointer should be pointing at P. So I told you when you are finding the probability, always you will write the formula first. Here it will be number of favorable outcomes. Divided by total number of outcomes. Okay, now in this you tell me what are the total number of outcomes, how many questions are the, is the circle divided into?
No, 5.
It can be 5. And this is the favorable outcome out of the 5.
Ma'am, D, because it is only one time.
So the probability of E will be 1 by 5. Understood?
Ma'am, can we also write as PE as in short form?
You also write like this only. That's why I am showing it to you now. If I am doing it, I expect you also to do that only. This is P of E means probability of the event. Always when you write P of E, you should not forget to write what is the event. Alright, now moving to the second one. What's the second one? Probability of getting an ace from a well-shuffled deck of cards. Now I have to test your understanding.
Ma'am, there are 4 ace cards because 4 symbols are there. For each symbol, there will be 1 ace card. So we can say that it can be 4 by 52, ma'am.
Yes. Now here the event is getting an ace card. Okay, so P of E will be favorable outcomes divided by total outcomes. Total outcomes we know because there are 52 cards in a deck, 52. The total outcomes will be 52. Which of these 52 are favorable for me? I want an ace card. They did not tell me whether it should be a black color ace or a red color ace.
Now there are 4 ace cards, 4 shapes.
Whether it's 4 ace cards. Particular symbol. Ace of hearts are there, ace of spades are there, ace of clubs are there. So ace of diamonds are there. But they didn't tell me I want ace of diamonds or flowers or spades or hearts. They simply said ace card. Sometimes they can ask ace in black suit. So how many will be there? There? An ace card in black suit. How many will be there?
Ma'am, 2.
Ma'am, 2.
How many will be there?
Ma'am, with black suit.
Black, it will be 2. Red also, it will be 2. But now they are neither specifying the color, nor they are specifying the suit. So simply, generally, they are saying ace cards. So how many ace cards are there in a deck of 52 cards?
4, because we
are 4 ace cards.
Four ace cards. Four ace cards. By 4 and 52? Is there a common factor?
Ma'am, we can go by 2.
Yes, ma'am.
Directly by 4, my dear, 8 and 8. 52 is there in the 4 tables. 13, 4, 52. So, P of E is equal to 1 by 13.
Yes, ma'am.
Alright, or if you get 2 by 26, again, you know, 1 by 13. Want to go by 2, you go.
Yes, ma'am, we can.
You can, but as you grow, you should know which is the common factor quickly. Alright. Okay, now moving on to the next one. What's the next question? Probability of getting a red apple in the given figure. So, in the basket, how many apples are there?
Ma'am, there are.
Ma'am, 7.
7.
How many apples are there?
Ma'am, 7.
Ma'am, 7
3 plus 3, 6 plus 1.
So, my event will be described as getting a green apple.
Ma'am, total number of outcomes will be 7.
So, your P of E will be favorable outcomes divided by total outcomes, which means the total outcomes is 7.
Ma'am, the question is getting a red apple.
Ma'am, red apple, ma'am, not green.
Red apple, of course. super blue. I'm getting a red apple. Oh. Out of these seven apples, how many are red in color?
From red apples, out of seven, four are there.
So four is the favorable outcome. So yes. The probability of getting a red apple is 4/7. Follow? Now moving on, let us see which other problem we can do. Okay, maybe we can do the fourth one and stop. Now fourth one is the number card. I think we did a similar problem yesterday. In the video, there was one shown later. So let us go to the fourth problem and try to understand what is asked.
Yeah, ma'am, the diagram of event question 3, should we draw that from the apple?
No need. It is understood, it is there in the text. So, or if you can draw it neatly, I don't mind. But don't worry yourself. Now look at the fourth problem. Numbers 1 to 10 are written on 10 separate slips kept in a box and mixed well. One slip is chosen from the box without looking into it. What is the probability of getting a number 6? So the first one, the event will be getting a 6 on the slip. Getting a 6.
No, 1/10.
So first you have to write what is the total number of outcomes. Outcomes also you have to write here. So what are the outcomes you have in this experiment? You have numbered cards from 1 to 10. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So total outcomes will be 10. The denominator will be 10. And number of favorable outcomes, you want only 6. So it can be only 1. It can appear.
And one time only 6 will come. So it is 1/10.
The probability of the event will be 1/10. Now the second one, the second event is getting a number less than 6. Getting a number less than 6. So which are the outcomes for less than 6? It can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So out of the 10, only 5 are favorable.
And 5 can be 1/2.
1/10 or your P of T is nothing but 1/2.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. The next one. Getting a number greater than 6. Getting a number
four.
Which are the outcomes there?
Ma'am, 7,
four.
8, 9, and 10.
Yes.
And so 4 by 10.
You should not include 6. So it will be 7, 8, 9, and 10. Which is 4 out of 10, which is
yes.
equal to 2 by 5.
Yes.
So P of E will be 2 by 5. Yeah? Then the fourth one. Getting a 1-digit number. Which are the single digit numbers in the complete sample?
No, 1 to 9.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. 1 to 9 are all real.
9 out of 10. So, getting of 1 digit number is your event. So, in the sample
yes.
of 10, only 9 of them are single digit numbers. So, it will be 9/10. So, your P of
9/10 will be the problem.
9/10. So I think that should be enough for us to complete this chapter. If there are a few more problems, maybe you can do it on your own. You can try. You can think of some more problems on deck of cards also, which is quite interesting. So I have given you a lot of work to be completed in your classwork. We are not meeting tomorrow because we don't have a class. And when we meet on Monday, we are going for a test on data handling and your construction. Construction also, I will include a few questions because it is not that MCQs cannot happen in construction. It can happen. I'll show you how it can happen. So go through your construction. Maybe I will not ask you to construct any quadrilateral because that is not possible in a quiz. But there will be questions related to construction. So you must.
Yes, ma'am, we have measurements. What required measurements that can be theory.
You have to read your textbook and try to understand what kind of questions will come. That shows your study of your textbook, how much you answer out of your textbook. Alright, so I think we will stop here. Let me stop the recording first.